dance on a power, stop abusing it. If it me say I chew me, put me life on it. NmNm, I like the word, go ask your girl. You support NmNm, say word. Fire views NmNm, interviews NmNm, best news NmNm. Dolly number 647-859-3539.
NmNm News. Right now we're at the last basic school, but it's very important. This is a basic school I used to go. The first name was Miss Lou Basic School. Now the name is Frazer's Content Basic School. NmNm News World Team are going right now. Food, I eat already, bunks about music. Everything set up with us. I'm going to go give the kids them what they deserve.
See that?
NmNm News, I've been to right now 10 basic school, and this is the last one before I go back to Canada. And I'm so privileged that this school is a school that me used to go to as a tenderest age, my first school. And here is the founder of this school, Miss Lou. Before this school, the name used to be Miss Lou Basic School, because Miss Lou is the person who, she is the one put this basic school in the community, will educate me and all of us, like generation of people. Fear and respect is out of this world. Me love her unconditionally, not only me, all the people on the street, because of what she do. You know what, one of the first question I have to ask you, what inspired you to come up with this school?
Because my daughter, you know, my first daughter, as I add, is she first started school, started out and eat a tree in the yard here. And afterwards she puts it in my hall, but my hall, I make sure put it in my dining hall. And I say it goes until my sister and sister-in-law from Pine Hill, they've introduced me to the basic school. It was the circle school we start. And then we introduced the basic school and tell me about the teacher trainer. And we started to go to the workshop and so on. And we started the school with the teacher trainer. She was Harper Johnson.
That was from in the 50s.
We started the school. That was in the 50s. That at that time she started. So my daughter leave the school and go to used to go work record office, go work and leave it and take it over. And we started and we just did this.
It's that are from the 50s.
Mm-hmm.
People, look.
Mm-hmm.
Before me, my parents go to the school. And then me come to the school, and this school is still here.
Mm-hmm.
This day standing. And right now, the school have 86 children, and them over there, them so strong. You have people leave from the school, and have do be so many successful in this life.
Mm-hmm.
We thank God. No, I'm older than you now.
Me? I'm 94 though.
94? You look beautiful.
You're sweating?
Yes.
I call them because they're not getting enough fun.
I'm sweating.
Ready.
already. NmNm News at Frazer's Content Basic School, Jamaica, with a beautiful teacher. No more than tell the world your name and the great class you teach.
All right, my name is Mrs. Aiti Lennon McNabb, and I teach 5-year-olds.
And how long have you been teaching?
I've been teaching for 10 years plus.
10 years plus?
10 years plus.
What are the best thing about teaching these children?
The best thing about teaching these children is to reflect on that first day that they come to you with so much potential and so much that they want to learn.
Yes.
You know, and at the end of the time when I'm gonna say goodbye to them, how much they have accomplished over the time. That's the best thing about teaching.
Keep it, she said. The best thing to share about teaching is the growth. She said the
gradual
coming,
yes,
and the ending growth.
Yes.
So she can see the work what she do, the plan. That's so beautiful.
Yes. Not just me, but them, because they have so much potential. It's just that they need somebody to just bring that out.
Mm-hmm.
In them.
Yes. So today we see you playing bingo with the children then. Tell me some kind of the game, some of the games that you play with them children.
Well, they like the outdoor games. Because you know, these children are very active. So they wouldn't mind staying outside all day. So they love the ring games and they like the singing. They love the singing, man. Right? So you can ask one of them to sing for you, they can sing.
Well, look here. Let me tell you something. Today, we're gonna find out everybody who can sing and dance.
Yes.
Because this is the last school we had, and this is the school that me used to go.
Oh.
Miss Scott, she was my teacher.
Yeah.
See my teacher there, the past year, she was my teacher. So I live right over there. So there's no going on. We are staying
right
the whole day. One thing more I tell the world now. Some of the stuff that you don't really want when you come next year, I'll bring to every school.
Alright, so you know that Frazer's Content is it's one of those inner city community, and the youths need help, right? So if we can impact on the youths from a younger age, it would be really nice. So resources would be a big help for us. Resources like books. Because books, you know, the value of book.
Expensive.
You understand? Games and, those early childhood games that children like puzzles.
Mm-hmm.
and the basics. Teaching material would be nice as well. And also, you don't forget about the technology. We are living in a technological world. So, you know, tablets and anything that has to do with on the technological side, that would be a real plus. And I see that you have been doing such a good work with the Bounce About.
Yes.
And the treating of them for today. We thank you so much. Because after they go through all of this whole school thing, you know, school sometimes can be pressuring.
Yes.
You know?
They need something to go.
Exactly. So same way, they have to be able to unwind and relax and
yes,
fun with it. So I want to thank you for what you have been doing.
You know what? Let me tell you something. They say, if you thank me, you never feel that way because
oh.
No, you know, more you thank me, I'm more you thank all of them. You see, NmNm News?
Yes.
It's a big team.
Right.
The team is so big and it's growing. So, more you thank NmNm News team.
All right.
Me.
Thank
whole team.
L.
NmNm News.
NmNm News.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you for the outreach program that you're doing for all our children. We appreciate it very, very much. Big up, big up.
People, let me tell you something. You see me, I stand behind this full by mission to Jamaica with all of my strength, my life, my soul. Until I die, I will never stop doing it. So more and give it up to all the people who help, all the people who share the same compassion.
Yes.
Each other like this, we love her so much because I see the vibes in her, you know, I see what she do with the children, and I see all them just respond to her.
Yeah.
And the main thing she said, our treasure is to see the growth.
Yes.
You understand me? We can't do nothing better. One love and God love you, and I thank God, and peace out.
Thank you.
With your Frazer's Content, my farmer basic school, when I was 3 years old, I was coming to this school. No, 2, I'm coming here.
Yeah. Yeah, and then you're long. 4 years.
2, I'm coming here. When I was 2, I was in this school. Thank God for life, I'm still alive and I'm here. And all the people who help, a lot of the things that you just say that you need, we have some of them right now.
Oh,
we have good. We have book, pencil, crayon time.
Right.
We have some play game.
Right.
We have so much stuff for people help. So we thank the Lord,
thank God.
And next year, this time we have 11 schools. And for next year, we need 14 more to make it 25 schools.
Yes.
So we are telling everybody, just come on with the strength and make it do it. Right now, we have an experience, because we go to Jamaica, this is the last school, and it's so, it vibes so nice. So just give us the strength so we can come back tomorrow, next year. It's coming like tomorrow to me, because we come back next year.
Yeah.
One love and a God.
Thank you.
Without God, we cannot live, we cannot move. So just trust in God, and everything you want, you will get. Peace out. NmNm News, it's a privilege to be here. We could have anywhere in the world, anybody want, but this is where I want to be. Right now, there is somebody, she's so powerful. She's the mother of our house, where we have children from every single household in this community. As a community where we born and grow. This is a house where teach me. Right now, more tell me more in me and all I've been teaching.
Now, I'm Mrs. Charmaine Scott, and I've been teaching for the past 34 years.
34 years?
Yes.
How long have you been teaching at Frazer Scott and Mrs.
34 years, approximately 34 years.
Never shake my head again. NmNm News full of barn tour in Jamaica. We're at the last school. And I feel so good for the year there because this is my school that I used to go. Right now, I have a teacher. She's from the community. Will you tell me what your name and how long you've been teaching?
My name is Marlene Williamson Forrest. I have been teaching here for 28 years.
28 years since so much. All of them changing up on the street past right now. NmNm News, right now, we're at Frazer Scott and Basic School, and we're with our teacher. We have so much respect for teacher, we especially teacher at this level. I love to tell the world in you and what grade you teach.
Okay, my name is Miss Spencer, and I teach a class 2, which is 5+. And I'm here about 23 years now at the Frazer Scott and Basic School.
23 years?
23 years at the Frazer Scott and Basic School.
So, and NmNm News, with the grace of God, we had Frazer Scott and Basic School in Spanish Town, St. Catherine, Jamaica. And we here with the teacher. Why tell the world your name and what grade you teach?
All right, my name is Mrs. Anoop, a.k.a. Auntie Poochie. I'm the teacher for the 4 years old.
And how long have you been teaching?
I'm here for 7 years now.
7 years at the school?
Yeah.
So you passed through, so a whole heap of them passed through already.
Yeah.
Even though you're so young in the school.
Yeah.
Me ask you, what the thing will make you even think about teaching children on this level?
Well, you know, because they're young, so at this age we're able to mold them from a younger age so that, you know, we're setting the foundation for when they go on to primary school and to an high school, so, yeah.
And what is your aim as a teacher when you get a first set of children and you have a turn to teach them? What are your aim? What are your pleasure? What are your aim?
Well, my aim is to teach them to the best of my ability, right? So that they can grasp whatever we're teaching, the concept, etc. You know, just to be patient with them because they're babies and that's what we are here for, to guide them.
What keep you coming back?
The children.
The children?
Mm-hmm.
And them keep you young like
yes.
This because?
Yes.
How do them changing up on the street past forever? What keep you coming back for these children?
The love. It's all about the love for the children. Yes. They are a part of me. Yeah. I just love children. And that's the reason why I go to this school.
So what make you come every day? What keep you coming?
It's love for the children, the job, and just love what you do. talking to them, working with them, it makes you feel good. And the parents, they are good parents, make you feel good. They appreciate you, they love you, they work with you,
yes,
and that keep you going.
There are a lot of people in the world right now, they want help, they want give, but they have a lot of stuff in them house who is vital with the school, but they don't know what to give. They can take a time and tell everybody like stuff that the school really need to help them at every level.
Well, I will touch the protection here first, which is the fencing, and you know, security will be good towards the school. Books, pencils, crayons, markers and so forth, and also, you know, things just to help with the ground, because as you can see, when it rains, it's very muddy and so forth, so whenever it rains sometimes, the children don't come out to school, so
you see the kind of year for so long, you know best what condition the school is right now, and what they really need. You can take your time, and just tell the world what you think the school are really need to help with education and structure. So it's a good facility so you can have a good brain to learn.
Computer, definitely. Internet. Because this world is going internet way, right? So obviously, having the children log on to the internet, that is a great, very, very much.
Long term on the floor.
Having the computer, yes, we need some computer and the internet as well.
So people, you see, this school, any kind of computer you have, laptop, any kind of device we can go up on the internet, any amount, any kind of how it look, it's really appreciated, so. Because we live in a modern time, as she said. And if you don't have access to the internet, there's a lot of things you don't have access to. Like Google, you don't have access to. It's cool. So anybody can do that, and really good. But I love it because you're here for 34 years. So you know best what the children need, what condition the school in. More if you can tell the world, like, what you don't really need for the children in this supplies, supplies and development in the school, or anything for education.
Right now, the most needed is to get a ceiling for the school, because then during the summertime, it's very hot. And as you can see, we need ceiling. We have the roof, the ceiling. So please thank you. When I need supplies like mostly crayon and paper and construction paper, things that they use, Antonin.
Yes. There's some things where the school needs to help it.
Like we need a proper fencing, keep the children in. We need proper fencing. We need the schoolyard to be done. It need renovate, it need to look much better. And we need some more pool area, things for the play area, like swimming, more things around the play area. And books, pencil, pen, markers, and all those things that we need for teachers.
Let me tell you something, you see right now, more you help me thank some people, because we have a lot of people help to make we get book, pencil, tiles, reading book, a lot of stuff we have right now to give to the school, crayons, pencil, all kind of stuff. So if you can thank Canada, any staff, all the people, we call you name right now, we have missed people, all the people help.
On behalf of Frazer's content basic, we'd like to thank all those who make it an effort to give the gift for the children and the teachers of the Frazer's content basic school. We want to say a big thank you to everybody that made it possible for you guys to be here. Even the community helpers, we see so many people from the community helping. We want to give them a big thank you on behalf of Frazer's content basic.
This is Spanish Town, Frazer's Content Basic School, capacity 86. And the teacher them have them so uniform and organized, and everything I run smooth like a train on a train track. Rolling, NmNm News Live. We are up! So much. Like, I talk to Miss Lou and more you tell if you can give your history of this school. Like, how this school come about in a year perspective.
Right, this school was started, I think, was in 1960. I can't remember the quiet years, but it was started by Miss Facy daughter, and then Miss Facy took over the school, and I'm of the school from 1993, and the principal was from 1993, which I used to work before that.
Yes, from 33 years, I would need to. People, let me tell you, when I was a little baby, she used to teach me.
Put in the photographer.
Even put. She teach me. Everybody makes me like
another shirt. 95% of people inside of me.
She teach all of them. She teach me. We love her so much. Like, me there beside her right now, it's an honor. It's a blessing. We love her. And for this mission, I want to tell the world this. I tell everybody, say, me talk to my teacher when she shaped me, and I mean, it was reason when we come here in 2010. That's here's a person who inspired me to do this full barren mission. Without you.
And I didn't know you would take up the challenge, I really did.
Yes, yeah, you understand me, because without this, see, because I've been to 10 more schools all over Jamaica, and without that reason that me and you had 7 years ago, none of this would have never happened. So we love you so much. Like, and then you know what? Me have to do this for the rest of my life. There's no one hurt could ever stop me from doing this. So we thank God for you. Everything you said to me, anything you want to say to me.
I said to you, tell you how much we love and appreciate what you are doing. Yeah, you're talking about what you are doing. So continue to keep all the good work. I'll do this other instance now. You're taking me a high five for that.
Yeah, and you make me do that. So every stop, everything will reach all the rest of 10 school. If it wasn't for you, it would have never been. Because if it wasn't for you, we would have never get it in my head. And the drive, if you start it, and if you don't start the car,
yes. And if you forget about they have teachers teaching here now who I taught. Who my teachers teaching here who I taught?
She's principal and teacher that was a student. I look on her. You say looking beautiful. Like,
pardon with the way after we've been so poor. But man, see them true colors. Yeah. That's why we do suffer. Man, see them true colors. Yeah. That's why we do suffer. Yeah. See them change when them weak.
We have a lot of stuff that people give us. We fight hard this mission to build Jamaica. So in a year we are, if we can come to Canada, to all the people who support us.
Well, I would like to say a big thank you to all those who have put together for this event to be successful today. I just want to give you a big thanks. And I just hope that you will never stop by giving, because when you give to these little children, you are reaching lives. Because when you reach the small ones, it is so great, and they will never forget help. When you help children, they will never forget the way you help them, and it will live on with them throughout their lifetime. So a big thank you, Canada.
And people want to make and thank God Almighty, because without God, this would never be possible, because of God carried this right through. You understand me? Right now, this is the beginning. Because for next year, we got help coming back. And we have 11 schools right now, 14 more for 25. So may I ask the world to just help this mission as much as they can so we can come back strong, vital for all these children. Just say a lot of words of advice to anybody who wants it. Education. Tell the world why it's important. Why this level of education is so important. That's why you spend your life in it.
This level of education, this is a grassroots, right? And when you get the grassroots right, then definitely there will be no problem in the future. When you teach them the right thing, when you try to give them love, when you try to make themselves know how to be forgiving and be friendly and be their brothers and sisters keeper, then after that, then it will be the best thing you can ever do for these little ones. Because doing, as I said before, when these children will never forget love. If you hate them, they know it. And if you love them, they know it. And it will live on with them throughout their lifetime. So when somebody do something good, remember, they will always remember it. And it will never die. It will never die. You coming here today, and you doing this for them. And when they realize that it is you, remember, even on the road when they see you, they are going to remember it. Yes, they are going to remember it. Because children never forget it. Their minds are very inquisitive and their minds are working
very
well. Yeah, man.
People, what she's saying is true because them IQ is out of the world. And if it's a farm, if you plant peas, you have to sow peas. So be careful how you live. If it's a father and mother, you're a mother and father for every children. So big man and big woman, just be big man and big woman for the children. Peace out, one love, God forever. And we need for a person like you can tell you why it's important for them to support a mission like this.
My advice is because we have so many persons who can't afford it. Like I've already sending their children to school and what have you. And a mission like that, if you can subsidize them for the books and what have you, that will be very vital.
People, it will be very vital. You hear from our mouth, and it's from the course of a million, so. Peace and love to the world. If you now say God, you're not speaking my language. It's just God and love. And anytime you see any enemies out for the children, Jamaica Basic School. This is Frazer's content. Basic School in Spanish Town, Frazer's content, Jamaica, St. Catherine. Peace out and just one love.
One love.
There's a lot of people who help this mission. NmNm News and the staff, because we carry some books, pencil, and a lot of stuff what we can, but we don't have everything. So if with your help, we can thank some people who help this mission.
Okay, on behalf of the Frazer's Content Basic School staff, students, the community members, we'd like to thank you all. Mike can't give everybody name, but you know, just a big thank. We really appreciate the help. And may the Lord continue to bless you, that you can continue to bless us and other schools.
Yes, you say, may the Creator help you, because without the Creator, we can't do nothing. And if you're not with the Creator, if you're not speak God language, I don't understand you. Just God alone, straight. So give it to the people that say the education, especially upon this level, is the most vital.
Yeah.
So this mission is a vital mission. I will never stop forever and ever and ever. And this time, look, this is the last school, because the level school we come to go to, and we go to 10 already. Last stop. And next year, we're going to try to get 14 more schools to make it 25. What do you think about it?
Well, I believe it's a good idea. It's a good impact on the kids. You know, they love the bunks about it. You know, the exposure, because some of them don't get the chance to go in bunks about. So this is free and food and so forth. So, you know, it's a good thing. It's a good thing.
We will never stop. This is NmNm News, and this is school I used to go when I was 2, 3, 4, 5,
Me
that
too.
Age. And she used to go to the school, and she's a teacher right here.
Yeah.
With person with cameras to go to the school.
Yeah.
Yes, tell me, so I want to tell everybody in the world, if you can help NmNm News, come to me. Find your basic school in Jamaica and we can come to your basic school and help them any way we can.
Yeah.
You understand? Because the youths are they are the kids and the man of they need everything today.
Yeah.
Don't think about tomorrow. So anything you can give them today, give them.
Yeah.
You understand me? So peace out, one love.